DC 2010, and we are at the 3rd annual International Pole Convention in Los Angeles. I'm representing X-Pole, which is one of my sponsors, as well as Bad Kitty Exotic Wear. I'm one of the brand ambassadors for the Pole Fit line. I'm here kind of supporting both of my sponsors, as well as I have my own clothing line too, so I'm sharing a booth with Palathia. I'm teaching workshops on Sunday at an outside location, but I'll be performing in the Bad Kitty Fashion Exhibition. I think what the Pole Convention does for our community is brings everybody together in a central location. It's kind of like a big family reunion for us because it's the one time a year that we all congregate into one specific area and we get to share moves, we get to share the experience with each other. We not only get so many wonderful vendors here sharing their products that are very specific for our industry, but we have so many different media outlets that attend too, and they're just getting the word out even more about pole. It's just a lot of fun. When I was a little girl, I liked to play in the mud and ride dirt bikes. So I was never a dancer or very feminine, never wore heels or makeup. If somebody told me when I was 10 years old that you're gonna grow up to be a professional pole dancer, I would have looked at them sideways. In high school, I had a friend who convinced me to try out for the dance team with her. Ended up they were taking everybody who just showed up for the tryout, so I was on the dance team. So that was kind of like my first exposure, like real exposure to any kind of like movement or dance, and I really liked it. Dancing is like a nice way for me to be able to enjoy the music, but also express through my movement how like the music moves me. I'm Karol Helms, and you're watching Pole World News.
Here we go, Karol Helms.
Yeah.
Yeah.